We look at teenagers. We see in a classroom that about 3 teenagers actually receive treatment for psychological health problems. If we look at people that visit hospitals, we see that psychological health problems are a little bit more common actually. It's 1 in 3 people that have experienced psychological health problems. And we see that in clinics like the asthma clinic, the cystic fibrosis clinic, they usually have a psychologist on the team to help people deal with their temporary psychological health problems. With PCD, nobody has actually asked anybody with PCD how they're feeling. And if they're experiencing any psychological health problems. So how do people develop a temporary psychological health problem? In a day, we experience a lot of different situations. Some of these situations might be familiar to us. We get out of bed, we have breakfast every morning, we go to school, we go to work. Some of these are more unfamiliar to us. For instance, we go on a first date, or we go on vacation for the first time, we take an airplane, or we have our first baby, or we're starting physical therapy for the first time. So some situations might be familiar to us, some of them are unfamiliar to us. Some of them cause us anxiety or stress, while others might not be so bad for us. So how anybody responds to any situation depends on multiple factors. One of them is personal factors, and the other one is coping. Personal factors might be, do we feel in control of the situation? Or do we have the skills to deal with the situation? Or do we have a very high level of tolerance for risk? Are we an introvert or an extrovert? What kind of personality type are we? The other thing is coping. Researchers have identified over 100 different ways that we can deal with situations. Some of them I've described here. For instance, you might involve family or friends to deal with the situation, or you gather a lot of information before you actually respond to a situation, or if you're stressed, you just laugh it off, or if you feel stressed, some people do yoga meditation, just relax their muscles and try to work through stress that way. So how do we develop a temporary psychological health problem? The example I bring here is from a show called Futurama, in which the character Fry, he wakes up 1,000 years in the future because he was by accident caught in the cryogenic sleep. So his personal factors and his coping factors determine if he's able to deal with the situation. It's very new to him, it's very unfamiliar to him. So he might be able to deal with the situation, and we see that he's developed friendships with Lila and Bender, or he might be freaking out and experience temporary psychological health problem. If we have multiple of these situations that stress us out, we might develop a longer term psychological health problem. Now, nobody has asked people living with PCD how they're feeling and if, about their daily events and if they experience any stressful situations. So I've developed a study that is actually asking individuals living with PCD what their daily events are like and what their PCD-related events are like. And I want to know what kind of feelings are they feeling. They could be happiness, sadness, they might be irritated, nervous, they might be sad, they might, any kinds of feelings that they're feeling over a period of time. I would like to know what their treatment makes them feel like. I want to see how they're supported in their daily life. It could be a friend helping them with their homework. Could be who they talk to when they're feeling sad or when they're feeling happy, who they share their events with. It might be who's bringing them to the hospital and they need to go there. And how they're coping with all kinds of different situations. For this, I've developed an online survey. I've developed 2 different kinds of surveys, one for adolescents and one for adults. is for adolescents and more appropriate for adults. The questionnaires contain 9 different questionnaires. Most of these have been used in some sort of form with other people with long-term illnesses like asthma or cystic fibrosis or other long-term illnesses. The survey takes about 45 minutes to complete. Any questions that anybody sees that they don't want to fill in because it makes them feel uncomfortable, they can just skip those questions. And the questionnaire is anonymous. I'm not asking for anybody's name or address. I only need, for the adolescents, I need the consent form to be filled out. So that will ask name and address, but it will not be on the questionnaire. So, with regard to the questionnaire, though it will be anonymous, then nobody will know that it's been completed and who's participated in the study. So, the adult questionnaire can be found at this website. For the teenagers, as I mentioned before, I would like the parents to give their consent before they participate. So, I've given information to the teenagers that I spoke to earlier tonight. Anybody that want to participate that I haven't spoken before, I have some more information available that I've taken with me. And it can be discussed with them and see if they'd like to participate in the study. I've also got some information about it for the adults with me. What do I see as the benefits of the study? It will give us a better understanding of how individuals living with PCD deal with daily and PCD-related events, how they feel supported to deal with these events, and it will give us an understanding of the distress that's experienced by individuals living with PCD. It will also inform us if psychological services would be appreciated as part of the PCD centers or any PCD service that's provided. And in some of the centers, some psychological services are currently being set up, so it will help those psychological services that are being set up. Like I said, I have some of the information available with me. Anybody is interested, you can give that to them. Any other questions?
Okay.
Another study that we're starting in Southampton. We're starting to set up a study that looks at the quality of life of children under the age of 6. In the previous 7 years, the Southampton team has set up quality of life questionnaires for adults, teenagers, and children from the age of 6 to 12 living with PCD. This project will be a collaboration between the PCD centres in the UK, collaborators in America, and collaborators in Australia. In November, we're starting to recruit between 20 and 30 parents of children 5 years younger. We're going to talk to them to see how PCD affected their child, as well as how it affected the family. And I would also like to know, I'm going to answer a couple of questions on how it affected the psychological well-being of the parents. Once we have that information, we're going to use that information to construct a questionnaire, a quality of life questionnaire. And we're going to give this preliminary questionnaire to about 100 parents to see if the questions are appropriate, if it actually measures how PCD affected